witness or mga saksi sa kamhanan o kundi sa kabuot kita ng Diyos. So dapat kita maruman, mentok butang-butang, we could see the hand of God working at the same time learn to be thankful sa atong Diyos. At kung diyan kita gamit sa tunga, katawag ng encouragement sa iba, ang tawag ng puso, nga kung si Indugino kapang hito. Okay? So mga kaon nagabi, magkala ko sa ating inadeligate o kaya ang visa at ang visa sa Manila, at sa atong padayang magkaroon niya atong Wednesday fellowship or midweek service. Okay, grabe mo kasi ang makonsulay this evening ay in connection man sa atong topic or the gospel reading Sunday about winning a brother, but at the same time also another angel. No? I have this in my heart last Monday when I'm sharing the daily office, but I cannot make it more say expound because I got only 10 minutes to share this. But since it's very important to us, no? When you could remember the gospel about winning a brother, it talks that says somebody talked about what's called an offense, no? And with his a brother said here that they've sinned against you or to other people, and we're gonna do. Said here to talk to your brother, go to your brother and talk about this matter. No? So we see here, why these things happen if we will not listen to you, get some of your brothers and talk again to that person. If they listen to you, get to the church, and if not, then make him like a stranger to you. So if you could just see what's happening here is that there's something happened here. Okay? Verse 15 says, moreover, if your brother sin against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. Here's you have gained your brother. Okay? So just listen, get two witnesses, and talk to that brother. He refuses, go to the church. And if he refuses, then treat him like a hidden or tax collector. Parang ganun, like, don't talk to him or just excommunicate him. As I read this, first of all, the thing that what God is here about, reconciliation, and unity and peace between us. So here, it says here, talk to your brother. If he refuses, go with other brothers, two or three, and talk to the person. If not, go tell to the church. If he refuses, then treat him like a tax collector or a heathen. As I meditated it, why is it that it takes the first attempt, talk to one another, refuses, talk with three persons, refuses, and talk to the church, refuses. Why is it that he refuses? That's all. I think, as you expound and think, because every time I study, why he refuses? He did come for so far, lot of problem with the first attempt. Muna God, I explain. Okay? But the point I want to emphasize here is that there's something happened. There's something happened. That's why I said here, if your brother sin against you, tell him his fault between you and him. When your brother sin against you, or he do something bad to you, tell it to your brother. So, if your brother sin against you, now, what about if you sin against your brother? Kung yung mga brother, nakasayakin mo ang bagay na. Now, kung ikaw, no, kung ikaw, willing ba mag-baton? O kundi, willing ba mag-humble man sa iba? The point I want to present this evening is that there is what you call, because your brother sin against you, it means there's an offense. Ngayon na tabo. No? So, here, we cannot really make it think that you're only the one your brother sins against you, that and also you sin against your brother or other people. There's always offense that would happen. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. In the house, in the office, in your barangay, or in your business, or even in the church, there's always offense. And the Bible says, you cannot avoid offense. This is what the Bible, Luke chapter 17. Luke chapter 17, verse 1. Luke chapter 17, verse 1. Then he said to the disciples, it is impossible that no offense should come. Nakita nyo? It is impossible that no offense should come. Imposible nga hindi mag-abot nga maka-offend ka iba o ikaw man i-offend. That's what the Bible says. Because all of us are growing in the Lord. We are all in the process of growing in the Lord. So the point, that there are times that some people would hurt you and you also hurt others. So there are always an offense. And you cannot avoid that. What God says here is that, but woe to him to whom they do come. Mas grabe kung ikaw ang ginahalinan. But point is that, there's always offense. Una nga, God says, if your brother sins against you, talk to that person. Or the one or others would also would, if you have seen others, would speak also talk unto you. Talk in a way, in a point of love, and the purpose and the motive is to arrange it or to settle it, and above all, once again, the relationship would continue and to win the brother. Because offense, okay, oh, offense is something that would be a block or a stumbling stone. Have you heard the word na stumble? Na stumble ang kimo. Na stumble sa ginamay ni brother. That's the meaning here. Okay? Offense here says is called scandalon or a cause opportunity to sin or a stumbling block. Sang kabato nga hanandat ka. Okay? Or scandalon of it, naging scandal. Naging cause of division, naging cause of shame, naging cause of problema. Or sa dictionary call it, it is transgression of the law. Ang boy sa the meaning of offense. Oh, kita mo, first offender, 500 pesos. Second, first offense, 500. Second, third offense, J. kundi man sa iba man, kabutan sa, huwag magtapo ng basura. Huwag magtapo ng basura. Multa o bubo? Nakasaya. Anong gusto mo? Multa o bubo? Mayroon ganun. So, it means to say when we offend somebody, it means we transgress or endure or wrong or sin somebody. This is the meaning of offense. So, when you put it like so there is, it is impossible that no transgression, no injury, no wrong, no stumbling stone or sin should come. So it is impossible that nothing in the bagage. It means to say you are the one that offended or you are the one that been offended. That is the story. No? The point is, that we learn to handle offense. The topic tonight is handling offense. Because that's way it will make it or will break it. How you will respond to that? Very, very important. Sa bagay, sa opisina, sa eskwelahan, sa negosyo, sa simbahan. How you respond or reaction to offenses that would make a difference in our lives. Because there are a lot of things right now, some people suffering because there are a lot of things that have been offended and they just keep quiet. They're silently suffering because you've been offended by others. And because you are not honest of yourself. If somebody asks you, it's okay. Filipino, madumot. But the thing is, it's going on inside of you. And people will not say anything about it. This is just, to keep it. Maybe they don't want to be a source of problem. Maybe they would tell me that I'm a one-break man if I show this to them. Maybe they would tell me that talagang dinggaruso ng tao ka. So they choose to keep silent. And they're suffering. Or, binalagaan mo ang sakit mo. Because you're not honest with yourself. To other people, what you really feel about yourself. Because sometimes you don't want to make a scene. Or sometimes you want to please people. You want to keep the peace so that no problem. It will never have peace. First within you and to the situation and to your family. Maybe offenses or sin would come because maybe they're immature people. You don't know what is right or wrong that you have done it. Maybe offense would come because it is unintentional, didn't really don't mean it, or it would be intentional. Whatever the case, the thing is to learn to handle it, because if not, then it will destroy us, destroy a relationship, destroy the whole thing, and destroy also yourself. Or we make it a situation where to grow in the knowledge of God, to grow, to be fruitful, to be forgiving, to be patient to other people. So there's always offense with God. There's always. in small situation or big situation, whatever sizes, small, medium, large, it's always offense. And here, God give us a practical already solution to this. Because if not, it always give more problem. Mark chapter 4 verse 17, this is the parable of the sower. The parable of the sower. So once again, you say sin or transgression, that's also meaning about offense or wrong, or sin again. So Mark chapter 4 verse 17. Parable of the sower. So it talks about the seed that comes from the heart of a man. So they have no root in themselves. 16. So Mark 4, 16, 17. This likewise are the ones who sow on the stony ground, who when they hear the word, immediately receive it with gladness, and they have no root in themselves, and to endure only for a time. Afterward, when tribulation and persecution arises, for the word's sake, immediately they stumble. Because of the word, maybe they've been persecuted, but because of the word, they stumble. Okay? And look at that. I read it in Amplified 17. Or 16. In the same way, the ones sown upon the stony ground are those who they hear the word, at once receive and accept and welcome it with joy. And they have no real root in themselves. So they endure for a while. When the trouble of persecution arises on the account of the word, they immediately offend. Offended, and mostly our colloquial word now, mas modernian, they were hurt. Yeah. I was hurt. Nasaktan ako. So mas modernian then, that's the word offend, nasaktan or hurt. Here, and here the gradual, if you don't know how to handle these offenses or their hurt, this is the level. And they have no real root in themselves, so they endure for a while, and they trouble, to get their eyes out of the word, immediately they offend them, become displeased, they don't like it, then I will be indignant. Now, first, they don't like it. Second, become indignant. So, wakangila, and then masaka mas higher level, indignant ka. Nahangit ka ba? O naatid ka ba? Then become resentful. Then become resentful. It means to say, they're displeased, indignant, and then resentful. You know, sabi nyo ulit. Why? It's because they have not settled it in their heart. They have not learned to handle it. That's why it become not only they become displeased, what's an island? It become now indignant and now resentful. My hatred. It's because they did not settle it. They didn't want us. Kung kaya mo palagpasin, okay. To make it past those things, so lang. Pero if you may imo sa libo, it's not okay. You're not honest to yourself. And that's why you are bleeding. Now, not only that, it says here, becoming displeased, indignant, resentful, and stumble. And fall away. Don't mean it again. Fall away. That's the gradual work. If you know how to handle offense, the end, they will fall away. What means to fall away? Now, we bring it in a level to understand. Some people, when they're hurt, before, they're very so energetic, enthusiastic, and when they're hurt, you can see them, they're long. They're, medyo malamig na, hindi pa rin. See, that's already a sign. They fall away. They fall out of the commitment. They're going to go to the church because other people. Let me say, they fall away because they're indignant to other people. In the church, or in the office, or in your barangay, whatever it is. I don't want to see that person. I don't want to talk to that person. That is a sign. A sign already. That you're indignant. And also a sign that you did not settle it. That's why they said, the Lord says, go to your brother, talk to him. So what? Only to yourself. You fall away. The emotion now controls them. Instead of their commitment, the emotion now controls. Bahala sa rura. It means to say that what you're feeling now is far more important than those things, or even to settle things, those things, or to make it a peace, so that once again everything will go right. So here, it's about immaturity, or maybe intentionally or intentionally. But the thing is here, the progression of that, if they have learned to handle those things, let those offense or hurt would control you, that would happen. It would affect your energy, your motivation, and with that also it become now, instead now you're now no longer a blessing to the situation. Even now you become also now another stumbling block. Unity, teamwork cannot attain because your heart is fully indignant. But here, God is saying to us, those things will happen. That's why it's very natural thing those things will happen. So don't be mesmerized, or don't think that you're so wondering what's happening, because that is very, very natural thing that would happen. The Bible says, when you're in the very earth, we'll face tribulation, all lot of problems, lot of trials. So it helps us to be prepared to know these things and learn the ways of God. How to handle these very practical things in life. But it would affect our life, our faith, our relationship to others, our working attitude, how you handle with other people, how you relate to people. It would be affected if we are not going to learn to handle offenses. Because offenses would always come. Maybe you're the one who offend, or you're the one being offended. That is very natural. But here, the Lord is saying to us that we're not to be to stay in that way, or to stay in the situation where you're always the victim. We should be more conquerable, victorious in the situation. Because the enemy could use this. Could use this to hamper our faith, to stop our commitment, Then we could use them. No longer people. Why people don't go to the church anymore? Because they're offended with something. Or maybe somebody or anything. That's why they're in the church. Or maybe in the office. Or maybe in the business. Or maybe your friends. Before. And now they're no longer friends. So whatever may be the case, maybe. Here's one of the source. And the Lord is giving us, teaching us how to handle it. And how to handle it? What is the ingredient? The ingredient is to grow in the love. Because when we sin against the love of God. So we have to grow in the love of God. Because the only way we learn how to handle conflict and offenses in life. If not, then your emotion will control you. Your emotion controls you. And then you think maybe Jesus justified. It's not justified, it's immaturity. Philippians chapter 1. How the Lord would teach us to handle offenses. Philippians chapter 1. This is the prayer of Saint Paul to the people of Philippians. And verse 9. Chapter 1, verse 9. This one, the prayer of Saint Paul. I pray that your love abound till more and more in the knowledge and all the sermon. This is a reading in last Monday. I pray that your love will abound till more and more in the knowledge and all the sermon. That is a prayer of Saint Paul, the Philippians. I pray that your love may abound until more and more in knowledge and all discernment. How the love of God would grow in us? By continual knowing God. The more you know about God, how He loves you, all His plan for you, your love also grows. That's why here it is. Combination of knowledge and discernment. The Word of God. Have time to read the Word. Because the Word of God will tell us how God loves us. The love of God unto us. And the more you know about the love of God, the more we grow in the love of God. So if you have no time to read the Word of God, to know the love of God, you will never grow in the love of God. So as simple as that. You have no time to read the Word. The Scriptures. You will never grow in the love of God. That's what I always tell you. No matter how faithful you are in the ministry, no matter how skillful you are in the ministry, without the Word, time will come, you go cold in your ministry. Even you're the one who's very talented, very skillful, very faithful. But without the Word, time will come, your commitment will grow cold. Kapang amig ka, kapang uyan. Because the Word of God is the one that would strengthen you, give power, give strength, motivation to our commitment. So, our reading of the Word of God will help us to grow in the knowledge of God. Then, if we do that, if we read the Word of God, we have time to meditate and apply it in prayer and indeed, then this would happen. That you may approve the things of the excellent, that you may be sincere without offense. I would read it in Amplified. And as I pray that to love abound yet more and more, extend to the fullest development, development in knowledge and in all keen insight. Knowledge and insight. That, so that, that your love may display itself in a greater depth of acquaintances and more comprehensive discernment. The more you grow, the more you read the Word of God, then your love would be displayed in a greater depth. Then what will happen? That is all. So that you may surely learn to sense what is vital. Verse 10. That you may approve the things that are excellent. That you may surely learn to sense what is vital, approve and prize what is excellent and real value. Recognizing the highest and the best, and dismissing the moral differences. That you may attain when tainted and pure and erring and blameless. What message is it? The more we read the Word of God, the more we grow in the love of God. And the more we grow in the love of God, the Bible says, we learn to discern what is right and what is wrong. It would help us to know what is bad and what is good. You learn to think much of others, much of yourself. Because most of the problem today, because we are selfish. The Bible says, things, if there is selfishness and conceit, there's always problem. Now, are you facing problem? Emotionally, whatever's wrong with that, first of all, be honest with yourself. There's always somebody, or all of you, or the two of you, is selfish. Or conceited. Maka sagali, you only think much of yourself, not of others. Because love will always tell us what is good to everyone, what is good to the all. We learn to know what is right, what is wrong. Learn to discern the vital, the excellent, the best. It's increasing the moral differences, what is right and wrong. With a pure heart, pure motives, and blameless. That blameless here for that without offense. Or, in other words, if you grow in the love of God, then, first of all, we will be people that would be less source of offense. O kundi, isang bago, mas madali nga gabago atong kabuhi, kay singkir na atong saga, singkir lang atong nga mo-offend. Then nag-grow on kita. You know it's what is right and what is wrong. So we become less more offender. We are less more aware the source of the problem. You are the source of the problem because you are not growing in love. You're selfish. We're just thinking of ourselves. That's why we are a source of problem in the house, in the office, in the business, in the barangay, or in your ministry, in the church, because we are selfish. We think much of ourselves, and we are not growing. So I mean to say, we have to grow in the Lord. All of us, we have to grow in the Lord. And the more we grow in the Lord, become far more the source of the problem. Bukod kita ay pinaugkas. No? Because we are growing. So, if still the pinaugkas, we're not growing. So, continue to grow, grow. Now, growing the Lord is a process. We cannot expedite. We cannot take it instant. It takes time to grow. That's why I pray also love. Learn to be patient with ourselves and learn to be patient with others. Because also growing in the Lord. And last it says here, that you may be filled with the fruits of righteousness. Now this thing will do now a very fruit of this life. For what is good. And I'm prepared to say here. That you may abound in filled with fruits of righteousness, of right standing with God, and right doing. Or right doing. Right standing with God and right doing. Right with God and doing what is right. If we learn to grow in the Lord. So this is for all of us. We have to grow in the Lord. Because I tell you, tomorrow, some people will always offend you. In your office, or whatever happens. Sad to say, people die together with their hair. And some people will call people before they die. And this is the time that we learn to ask forgiveness without even dying. They're in the deathbed. Why not say that early? So that maybe before you die, you have a lot of things in common, a lot to enjoy life. Bonding, bonding, sharing, sharing, eating, eating, sex, whatever to do. Why not? Why wait? You're dying and then sit on the stage. That's what happened. And if you ever said that you have to forgive your enemies before they die, why wait before they die? You suffered a lot. But if you do, if you like that, then do it. Kung style mo. But God said, learn to forgive, learn to be patient early. You know, I have prayed a lady, 117 years old. My God, thank the Lord, 117 years old. I am so intrigued. What did you do in life? The first thing I asked, did you eat pork? Yes, I ate pork. They have no high blood. Little pork. I eat pork. Do you drink? Yes, I drink the pork. So what more? He's not maybe simple or between indigent and simple people. So what's your secret, Lola? Say so quickly. Do you go to church? Yes, once a week. Then I ask another question. Because these old people, one is that they don't understand stress. So I ask another question. Lula, nag-uugtas ka sa inyong mga. Does your problem, does your children give you problem? Because that's a source of stress. Maybe your husband, or maybe your peace, whatever. You say, yeah, but I tell them, just tell them what to do. After that, it's up to them. It's up to them. I just tell them. It's up to them. It's what you say. Pag sinabi ko sa kanila, pahalas nila. I will not, if I have to read the word, I will not, resentment, or ang masakit buo. It's up to them. So this old woman knows, learn to forget, and if you do it, it's up to you. So you have no emotional stress, whatever, that's why you live long. People today die young because of so much stress. Unforgiveness, hurt aches, whatever things in life.
I said, it's very possible to live 174.
Very possible. More than 100. And here, how much if that woman, if that old lady only go to church once a week? Once a week. I don't know about their Bible knowledge, but it did long. So what about you and me? We have known the Word of God. We are here every Sunday, Wednesday, every morning. And what are the secretaries? They have no spirit. Because they have no heartaches, they have no sakit buhok, can be self-forgiving, and you live long. More challenge for you and me, brothers and sisters. We have the Word of God. We know what the Lord says. For more challenging for us. So, it will help us to understand things around us. That nothing, everything around us is imperfect. But we have a perfect God. So, help us to handle offense, you always come every day with the love of God. And may God be glorified in us. So continue to grow in the love. Talk to your brother if you desire, because you want things to be setting out. Relationship will continue. And continue to grow in the love. Learn to forgive. Learn to be honest with yourself, because what's your feeling. Learn to pray. You have all things God has given us. But never be that those offense would imprison us. Will not be the victim of your